Coming up next on Jonathan Bird's Blue World, Jonathan feeds the world's most dangerous shark.
Hi, I'm Jonathan Bird, and welcome to my world. Sharks are perhaps the most misunderstood animals in the ocean. In spite of the fact that people are only very rarely attacked by sharks, they suffer with a bad reputation. While the world's largest shark, the whale shark, is known to be harmless to people because it's a filter feeder, other sharks have been known to attack people occasionally. The tiger shark and the white shark are two of the largest so-called man-eaters, and they have an equally large bad reputation for being extremely dangerous to people.
But what if I told you that these are not the most dangerous sharks? In fact, the most dangerous shark in the world is probably the bull shark.
It might seem hard to believe. The bull shark looks just like a reef shark, but a little bigger. It doesn't seem all that intimidating. So what's the big deal? As it turns out, bull sharks are responsible for more documented attacks on people than any other species of shark. In 1916, there were several people killed by one or more sharks off New Jersey in the span of 2 weeks. At the time, most people suspected a great white shark, but one of the attacks occurred more than 10 miles up a river, and white sharks have never been known to venture that far from the ocean. It's much more likely that the attack came from a bull shark.
The bull shark is the only species of shark that regularly moves between saltwater and freshwater. In fact, it's been caught by fishermen more than 500 miles up the Mississippi River in Illinois.
Shark attacks are rare, and most often they're believed to be a case of mistaken identity, since attacks on swimmers often occur in shallow, silty water where the shark has a hard time seeing its prey clearly. Nonetheless, bull sharks are considered extremely dangerous animals under some conditions.
Which is why I was so excited when my friend Jorge Loria from Phantom Divers in Playa del Carmen invited me to come film these sharks. He's hand-feeding them!
I fly on down to Mexico, landing in Cancun, then heading south to Playa del Carmen, a beach lover's paradise and my favorite place in the world for cenote diving. But this time I'm not diving the cenotes. I'm heading out to a secret dive site in the ocean, hopefully filled with sharks. Big sharks! I make my way over to Phantom Divers to meet my old buddies, Jorge and Charlie.
Hey, Jorge, Charlie, how you doing? You guys ready to film some sharks?
Charlie and Jorge have been feeding bull sharks for a few years, and they give me a few tips on what to expect and the best way to film it. And of course, some safety tips.
Well, it's very important, never lose of sight that bait. No, okay. Don't have the bait and be looking this way. Right. You gotta be looking at the bait the whole time.
Right.
Okay, because it could be that a shark comes for the other way.
Right.
Usually they come from the front.
My wife Christine and I head down to the beach to climb aboard the Phantom Diver's boat. Then it's off to the dive site on a beautiful sunny Mexico day. Before long, we've reached the dive site, and Charlie suits up in his stainless steel shark suit. He'll drop down a few minutes before the rest of us to get the chumming started in advance. This saves us some bottom time for filming. Now the rest of us get suited up and prepare to dive. As usual when diving with sharks, I cover up so I don't have much skin showing.
Well,
Let's go see some sharks. I descend towards the bottom through crystal clear, warm water and eventually end up on a sandy seafloor at a depth of 80 feet. A stingray glides past. It can smell the fish Charlie brought down. Jorge takes over for Charlie and hand feeds the growing school of hungry mouths. I stay back a ways so I won't spook the sharks. I know it's hard to believe, but our scuba bubbles are loud and scary to sharks. It doesn't take long for the first couple of bull sharks to arrive, but they keep their distance, not sure what to expect from us. A few minutes later, they approach Jorge closer to see where that yummy smell is coming from. But they're not ready to trust him enough to take the fish from his hands. Even the stingray has managed to procure a snack from Jorge. I'm starting to think these sharks are wimps. At last, the first shark makes her move. She takes the fish right from Jorge's hand. The next shark actually misses the fish and doesn't have the maneuverability to turn around and get it, so she finally gives up and goes around again. Now that the sharks have figured out that we're not a threat, I can move a little closer to Jorge for filming and the sharks won't mind. Jorge's steel mesh gloves protect him from the shark's teeth just in case his fingers get too close to their mouths. The sharks have a voracious appetite. They keep eating until we're all out of fishy snacks. I can't help but notice how monstrous they are compared to a diver. Bull sharks might look like reef sharks, but they get a lot bigger. At last, we've reached our bottom time limit, and it's time to ascend towards the surface. While we do a safety decompression stop near the surface, the sharks come up to investigate. Clearly, they've overcome their apprehension about us. In fact, it kind of seems like they don't want us to go. Jorge has one last piece of fish, and he offers it to the sharks as a parting gift. At the end of an exciting dive like this, I can't help but be totally pumped.
Whoa! Those sharks are huge! I can't believe I'm gonna get a chance to feed them!
Later, back at the dive shop, I chat with Jorge and Charlie about what I'll be doing tomorrow, wearing the chainmail shark suit.
All right, so have you ever wear a chainmail before?
No, never.
Well, these things are very heavy. They're about 30 pounds, the full suit. Uh-huh. So we're gonna put on the suit. It's very important that you put your boots over the suit, because if not, on the boat, it's super slippery and you can hurt your ankle like I did yesterday.
Okay, that's good advice.
Put the boots on, and then when we go in the water, it's very important that you put a lot of air in your BCD so you don't sink as a rock. Okay. When we get to the bottom, completely deflate that BCD, and I'm gonna start the feeding part, you know, so the sharks get close to us, and once we get the action, I'll hand the chum bucket to you. Me and Charlie will be right behind you. You'll be fine, man.
I'll be fine. I'm gonna wear chainmail, man. It's gonna be so cool!
The next morning, we head back to the same dive site on another beautiful flat calm day. Boy, do I love diving in Mexico. Once again, Charlie gets in first with his container of bait to get the action started in advance, while I learn how to put on the chainmail. The chainmail suit is made of thousands of interlocking rings of stainless steel, which form a kind of fabric. It's super flexible, but the sharp teeth of a shark can't bite through it. Unfortunately, it weighs 30 pounds, so I'll sink like a rock when I hit the water if I'm not prepared.
Jorge, of course, is diving with me, as is a shark biologist named Mauricio Padilla, who will be attempting to take a tissue sample from a shark.
One, two, three.
I sink rapidly down to the bottom in my 30-pound shark suit. When we arrive, Jorge hands me a piece of fish, and now it's my job to entice the sharks over. We were feeding yesterday, so it doesn't take them long to come on over. As I wave my piece of fish around, Mauricio is behind me, waiting for his chance to take his tissue sample. Soon, a big bull shark comes up and takes a close look at the piece of fish I'm offering. She likes what she sees because she makes another pass around and takes it gently from my hand. Jorge takes a turn next while I grab another piece of bait. Then I feed again and the shark makes a nice close pass to a few other divers that are watching. The sharks are calm and relaxed, just like us. All this time, Mauricio has been hanging back, watching the sharks and making notes. He knows which shark he needs the tissue sample from, and now it's time to make his move. He has with him a spear gun, but instead of a spear, it has a special tip designed to grab a tiny sample of skin and muscle from a shark. The heavy chainmail makes my job really easy. I'm planted on the bottom. Mauricio has to be patient. The shark has to be really close because its skin is so tough. He has a camera mounted on the spear gun so he can identify the shark later. At last, the right shark comes close and Mauricio fires. The gun camera footage shows perfect aim. The tissue sample came right from the thick skin at the base of the dorsal fin. The shark absolutely feels a pinch, but the sample does not harm the animal, and in fact, she comes around and feeds again. Inside the tip of this instrument is a tiny sample of the shark's tissue that will be used to learn what these sharks normally feed upon, and if they're interbreeding with other populations of bull sharks around the Caribbean. Later, I chat with Mauricio about his research projects. Bull sharks are only one of the species he's studying in Mexico. And then he shows me the tissue sample we got.
So this is the core, and we have, you can see the muscle. That's the red thing, that's the muscle.
Yeah.
And also we have the skin. And we are gonna do two kind of analysis. With the skin, genetic analysis, in order to know if this population is related with other populations. And with the muscle, we are going to do an analysis that it's called stable isotope analysis. With that, you can know if the sharks, when they are here, are feeding on coronado or remoras or whatever.
So how many have you taken so far?
11.
11 biopsies. 11 biopsies. That's probably not enough to learn much yet.
No, we need at least 30.
Mauricio's sampling program, combined with some satellite tagging, is already shedding some light on the mysteries of the bull shark. And Jorge's hand feeding is helping to dispel some myths about these sharks.
Well, there you go. I fed the most dangerous sharks in the world. Man-eaters? What do you think? I don't think so. In fact, I had so much fun, I'm gonna go see them again.